Let us connect through our circle. Simply allow the energy to flow, for your higher self, of course, knows how to do it. It opens our hearts as the energy from the heart moves into our circle. We are all connected by divine love. And those of the higher realms who work with us know each one of us individually and sends to us constantly such divine love. It's inconceivable in human terms. The love for oneself. The love they have for you is immense, and never doubt that they are with you at every moment, and whatever your soul's design is, it is with love. So open your hearts a little more to feel that love which they have for you, which is beyond human comprehension. It is huge. They see us, of course, through all dimensions of our soul. They honour the sacrifice we made to come to Earth. And they support us as much as we are able to receive their support in the mission that we are here to carry out. For we have come here from a higher realm to hold the light and to radiate the light to humanity, to all life, and to this earth. We are essential to the plan of ascending this planet and all life. At the same time, we ourselves are not given an easy time for the service that we are here to carry out, for we are the ones that are strong enough to assist in clearing the karma of humanity, of this earth. And through the challenges that we take on, as we move through them, we gain great evolution for ourselves. We are evolving our souls ourselves tremendously. So let us enter in now to the Arcturian Crystal Temple as we feel the Arcturian consciousness around us, beginning to feel the love which they have for us, the comforting, kind, and unconditional love which we are able to feel here. We do not feel threatened. We are not in fear as we enter into the frequency of the crystal temple which surrounds our circle and each one of us. So let us settle in. There are so many energies entering in through our aura at this time. All the rays are coming to us, penetrating our aura, entering into our being and into every cell of our bodies. It may sometimes seem overwhelming, yet we know that we have been decided on a soul level that we will fast track. So everything is speeding up. The intensity of what we need to clear and release, and the rise in frequency which the body has to handle and which we all need time and space to integrate through our four bodies. We trust in the divine plan. And we allow our consciousness to expand upwards and outwards into the higher dimensions. Whilst feeling the bliss and choosing to experience joy and unconditional love, the human self also has its clearings and releasings to go through. And we are at this time moving towards a full moon, which will create a further release from us of what still needs to go. It does require your intent to let go of your hurts and wounds, your past traumas, and all your suffering. As you move into higher frequency and feel the self within, you come to a point where you don't feel you need that past anymore. And it begins to dissolve away in the power of the light. So while we come together here in the crystal temple, we ask the temple masters to transmit to us through this brilliant etheric crystal, which becomes ever brighter as we gaze upon it, the assistance which we need to heal and release our past burdens. So be in your stillness. Allow the energies to pass through you as you remain still within, with the intent that you are ready to release your attachment to your past. They will, of course, be communicating with your subconscious, for there is much there that we are not even aware of, that we hold on to, which create our issues and suffering in our present time. As you become more observant, as your level of self-awareness rises, more of what lies in your subconscious will come into your consciousness. You receive these energies. Feel unconditional love for yourself. You may notice that in your past you have carried the belief of low self-worth, that nobody really cares, that you are alone in this world. You may hold anger. You may feel such sadness. And an inability to forgive yourself. Allow all these emotions to flow if they are there. From a higher place of self-awareness, you look upon them without attachment. You are not identified with them. And as you experience more of the blissful nature of the fifth longer seem important. And Kuan Yin is with us all now in the crystal temple, bringing compassion. And as she brings compassion to us, we also have the ability to feel that compassion for oneself. Nothing is judged. All that is important is love. To have self-love, you cannot move into the fifth dimension without self-love. Feel the light within you, your oneness with Source. And the love from the higher realm, directed into the heart of each one. Nothing is judged. You only judge yourselves. As you judge yourselves, so you judge others. So you feel anger about what may have been done to you and find you cannot forgive. As the love of Kuan Yin enters, it softens your heart. You begin to experience the beauty of being in love. And all that is not of love simply dissolves away. Is meant to be as it is. It was your soul's plan that created all the situations which disturb you, which pain you. Accept that it was of your soul's choice, and and there is no one else to blame, and that you chose the experience for your growth and evolution. As you experience the greatest sadness, it transforms into the greatest joy. All negative emotions transform through love. Into their opposite, until all fear is released, transformed into love, and only love remains. Feel how the energies are moving through you. Without resistance, and we do not need to make any effort to allow our transformation to take place. We feel the beauty of the light. The love that encircles us. We enter into bliss and we choose to be in joy. The Kundalini energy is rising as you feel it pushing upwards through your core, through your chakras. It is the divine feminine healing along its way. As it comes to balance the divine masculine, the love of the mother, the Christ in love, which also comes to us from the sun. So we are preparing for the balancing of the two. As you feel your connection to the core of Mother Earth and her rising energy, you are lightened and uplifted. Not only does your frequency rise, but you experience yourself from your core. And from your third eye, you gaze upon your sun. You receive from the consciousness of the sun, the Christed light of Jesus Ananda. Jesus and Mary, together within your high heart, coming into perfect balance and harmony. As all lower emotions about self are replaced with the higher feeling of self-love, self-acceptance, self-worth. As your inner power gains strength, as you know yourself to be at one with Source, a part of Source, a part of the whole, and your consciousness has expanded into the galactic consciousness of which you know yourself to be a part. The little me being replaced by the greater self. So why not let go of your identification with the little self and simply give it your divine love? As the divine feminine and divine masculine begin to come together in balance and harmony, you will have a connection to your high heart and higher mind. So bring your focus now to your high heart and your higher mind. As the Arcturians work with us to create that connection and bring all into balance. As this connection gradually takes place, so the opening of your third eye, your intuition and higher abilities will all be activated within you. You will open up to the higher planes of existence. The reopening of that which was shut down a long time ago. And you may be experiencing your pineal gland, your third eye. It is love which allows this connection. As you return the Christ itself and the purity within. So these higher abilities will unfold within you. Receive the love that is offered to you. Learn to love yourself. Let go of all the illusions and adopt higher thoughts, higher feelings. Return to the oneness.